these cars run in the Delhi area, and they were incredibly difficult for us to procure. So this corridor is the corridor that Peter first walks on as he gets on the train. And these are traditional Rajasthani patterns. You'll find them in any palace, and they've been making these for hundreds of years. Our friends the elephants, some of the most beautiful things that happened on this movie were some local Rajasthani painters that we came across who just sat here. This elephant might have taken a guy a day. And there are no less than 500 elephants all over our train. Each one of them, each flower, each little piece of its decor, hand-painted with a teeny little brush. Each elephant with a different personality. These walls are all on a track. So that when they say, we need to put the camera there, we literally, by popping out the last wall, can slide the whole exterior section of this down there. Similarly, the side walls are all on hinges and the windows are rigged, as I said. Anything that's on the ground is on wheels. Up here in the ceiling, we had a piece of track from which we hung the camera because we had a very hard time figuring out how to move a camera on wheels on a moving train. And this I-beam up here had an attachment, a dolly that hung down. And the camera was operated standing up, but without the camera ever touching the ground. It was a very fluid way to go down and back. This is the galley. The galley existed solely so that Rita could make sultry eyes from here down to Jack at the far end of the corridor. The dining car is our showpiece on our train. This was the place we had the most fun working. Chandeliers, the bar, portraits of Maharajas. If you stand right there, the glass door. One of our characters runs through. The dining scene was a long scene where the brothers really found out why they've come on this journey. It took place at this table. Everything in this set is handmade. That's what's amazing to me. Handmade. We showed a guy a chair. How do we get some of these? Don't worry about it. I'll make them. Hand block printed fabric. Hand blown glass. Hand painted plates. Every one of them. This, you might guess, is the kitchen. This is the Hero Cabin, Cabin 40, 41, home of the Whitmans. And this is where a great majority of our story takes place. The window. It was all about these windows. These are nice, big, almost anamorphically shaped windows. Different filtering can be put into these windows so that we could balance what was outside with what was going on inside. The car you're in now is normally the fourth car on our train. We call it the Hero 2 car. Reason being is, we had created a cabin where the story takes place, and we figured out that the train goes in two directions. So we needed a mirror image of the first car, so when the sun changed or when the direction outside the screen changed, we'd have a place to go. The big creative decision Wes made was that we were going to shoot this movie on a moving train, and all that does is complicate life. It makes it more expensive. It makes the logistics impossible. It made it incredibly difficult to figure out how much crew, what gear. How do you do a shot from out there looking in here on a moving train? Not so easy. But what it did do in the end, and he was right, what it did do is it made it real.